So, Dan Johnson here interviewing Darren, and we want to kind of go back in time a little bit. We're standing in front of one of your iconic yellow airplanes that everybody knows by now. And how'd that all get started, Darren? When and where, and a couple of details about the long ago past.
Actually, we started the company. We actually came to Oshkosh in 2004.
Oh, was it right when the rule
came
out?
Right when the rule came out, and I came out here to buy a Super Cub kit.
You didn't know the rule was coming.
We knew Lightsport was coming out. We just said, you know, I want to buy a kit to put an airplane on floats. And I went to that kit manufacturer, and he told me it'd be 18 months before I got my kit.
Wow.
I says, there is no way I'm waiting for 18 months for a kit. So my history has been in Cubs for 30 years. I grew up and had a Cub when I was 19 years old.
Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah. You're like 29 now, right?
Yeah, I'm 29.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
plus a few more years, but yes. But I came here.
You got started early then. Cool.
Yeah, 19 years old, and I went to my local hometown bank and took a loan out for $6,000 and bought a Piper J3 Cub.
Is that right?
And got out of college and got my first job down in Texas and restored the airplane in 1991. And at Oshkosh, I won a Lindy Award for restoration at 27 years old.
No kidding. Well, I didn't know that about your history, so it's good I asked. That's great, Darren.
So I fell in love with Cubs a long, long time ago, and just enjoy
kinda
them.
Never look back.
Yeah,
huh?
I just, you know, I call them my therapy airplane.
So. Very cool. Well, also interesting because you were going to buy a Super Cub kit.
Yep.
And now you have something called a Super Legend, and it's on floats. We're going to have a look at it in a minute.
That's right. But what I did is that, you know, we kept a real simple approach. We wanted to keep the qualities of a Cub in place. So a friend of mine and I got together, and we did the crazy thing of saying we're going to start an airplane business. And so we built two airplanes from scratch. We kept it all quiet because we wanted to be a proven company that wasn't a paper airplane. And so we built two airplanes starting in 2004 of October. And we built the airplanes like we wanted. We wanted to make it a little bit wider. We looked at all the safety improvements through STCs and all the airworthiness directives. And we just thought of everything possible we could do to make that airplane just a better airplane and manufacturing techniques and stuff. So we built two airplanes from scratch, got tooling built, and hired some employees. And in 2005, we showed up at Sun Fun with two
decked out with your outfits too. I remember that part. Tim Elliott helped you get that.
That's
all
right. We had those boots on and our outfits, and we had a good time. But you
made quite a splash there with that.
We did a good splash.
It was a good idea.
So we ended that show with 16 aircraft sold. We got deposits and checks.
Wow.
So
obviously you struck a chord then. Not only were you one who was a Cub enthusiast, you found there were a lot of them.
Well, the girls loved the boots, you know, and that's what made the sales.
But of course. But you did stuff like I'm looking right here, you know? You got a door on this side. Your Piper J3 Cub didn't have a door on that side.
Well, the reason we did that is because I'm a seaplane guy, and I love flying on floats. So I said, you know what, I'm building an airplane where I want it.
So you can get out both sides.
Yeah, I get out both sides.
Deal with the floats.
I don't have to do those turns to the right. I can do the turns to the left. Why you've got everybody down there, you know, on the farmland stuff. So, you know, it's just a good reason to do it, and we just made it standard for every airplane.
Cool. Well, let's go have a look at the Super Legend on floats and see how things might be a little different with that one.
That sounds great.
We shift the gears here a little bit. We're overlooking at a Super Legend. Says so right on the cowling, so I know that's true. Looks like some carbon.
Yes.
Got a little carbon elements in this airplane?
Well, what we did is that when we did the AL-18, we had to look at everything we could do to get the airplane a lot lighter.
Because you wanted to put a bigger engine in.
Well, we have certification requirements that we have to meet a minimum empty weight of the aircraft. And so we did a lot of lighting features to make the airplane, you know, through carbon fiber and lighting and everything else that we can do through the airplane. Now, we didn't jeopardize any of the structure. We kept the same airframe that's used in the AL-3 and AL-11 is the same for the AL-18.
Okay.
So we wanted the strength, but we did a lot of things to make the airplane
where you could take weight out without affecting the structure.
Right. So we use carbon fiber for our floorboards, our baggage compartment, our doors, our cowling.
What kind of weight did that trim off? I don't expect the detail here, but By doing all of that, how much were you able to slice off the airplane?
Well, if you compare what we have, of course, we use the Lycoming 0233 engine, which is a lot lighter version of the 0235. Our airplanes are coming in on average about 860 pounds empty weight on land.
Okay.
So we're very light compared to a Super Cub Piper,
which is
about 1,100 pounds.
Oh, wow. Okay. So yeah, you're quite a bit lighter.
Yeah. So we got the weight down. That's with, you know, the avionics and lights and everything's in the airplane. We're running by 855 to 860. So we feel real comfortable. We made a more comfortable seat, you know, a bungee seat in the airplane.
Okay.
And of course, our airplanes are 3 inches wider. And
Than the original Cub, or than your earlier models?
All the J3s and
okay.
The Super Cubs,
okay.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I like to say we're a little bit more prosperous today than we're back in the 1940s, and that's usually in this midsection right here.
Right. You know what? Well, we got to eat a hamburger to keep those guys in business, too.
Yeah, so. That's right.
Well, this one's sitting on some very nice floats.
We have 5 amphibs already sold, so customers are waiting for those airplanes.
All right, we better get back to work pretty soon. But, you know, Darren, I got to say this. We got a lot of great airplanes coming in from other countries, and that's great. They make some nice airplanes. Some people really love them, and they've been buying a bunch of them. But, you know, Americans are kind of partial to stuff that's all American. You're pretty much an all American company, aren't you?
That's right, we are. And you know, this is an American icon. I mean, you can go to any airport and pull up to the gas pumps
in the world.
In the world, yes. And everybody recognizes a Cub and as an American icon. So, and we're American built, and we're proud of it. And down there in the factory, you know,
down there in Sulphur Springs,
Texas. That's right.
Which is, as I recall from visiting you at the factory, it's north and east of the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Correct?
That's right. We're 75 miles east of Dallas.
Just far enough out to enjoy it when you want, and not have to hassle with you when you don't.
That's right.
It's a nice facility there. So, Darren, tell us some of the things that you told us a little bit about what you did when you re-engineered this product. Tell us some of the specific improvements that you made to the airplane that our viewers might be interested in hearing about.
Well, on the Super Legend, we did a lot of improvements as far as making it a little bit better performing aircraft. For instance, the AL-3 doesn't have flaps, and the AL-18 Super Legend has flaps.
And none of the J3, J4, J5, they didn't have flaps, right?
Right. So we added flaps, and we have bigger tail surfaces on it. We used the Lycoming 0233. And the big thing about the 0233 is it's multi-fuel approved.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, so you can use autogas.
We can use autogas, 91 octane, no ethanol.
That's kind of a big deal, yeah.
And, of course, I talked about the nice seats we did there. The front seat is now adjustable, and so you got adjustable front seat.
Which was not the case on the old Piper's Air.
That's right. Yep. So we got the front seat. And then this particular airplane, we did a lot of improvements as far as avionics. This is actually the first 2020 compliant ADS-B compliant aircraft.
Ah, is that right? Okay, so you're all set with what Mr. Huerta wants out of us?
That's right.
We're done now.
We're done. We use a free flight system that gives you the ADS-B out. And, of course, we use the TRIG transponder, which is the ADS-B compliant transponder in the airplane. And then we get our information from Garmin, the GDL-39.
Now, you're supplying airplanes in ready-built specialized sport aircraft. But you're also doing kit aircraft, are you not?
Yes, we do. We do have kits, and we sell quite a few of them. We also support a quit build program where people come down to Texas and spend 21 working days, and usually it's done in 2 different phases, and they can build their own airplane there at the factory.
And in 21 days, they can get most of it or all of it done?
After 21 days, we have shown on track that we can get you out the door and get your test flight done. But you have to remember, most of the ones we do are ELSA, and we don't have the 51% rule.
Right, you can help them just as much as you want.
That's correct.
So, and that's what you do then.
Well,
so folks come down to visit you at Sulphur Springs for that?
We are there to train you how to build an airplane or build our airplane. Now, we don't build your airplane.
You don't actually pull the rivets or do anything
right.
like that.
We have, as usual, a one-on-one.
You assign somebody to work with that.
Work with them the whole thing, and they build the airplane. But they benefit. It's sort of like paying for a college education. They can you pay to go to college, where you're paying us to teach you how to build an airplane. You're using our facilities and stuff.
Yeah, it's got to feel good though when you're doing it to have the expert right there to go. No, don't do it that way.
Right.
Do it this way instead. This will work a lot better for you.
And your airplane turns out just as high quality as one of our production aircraft.
Sure, I'll bet. Okay, so that's a lot of good stuff here, Darren. Thanks for taking the time with us today. But people always want more. Where are we going to find you on the web? We'll put it on the screen, so just give us your web address.
Well, this is, of course, the www in front. It's legend.arrow.
Legend.arrow.
And that's us, and our phone number is 903-885-7000. So it's an easy number to remember.
All right, there you go. Say it once again.
903-885-7000.
It's easy enough that he could remember it.
Barely.
Great stuff. More things on American Legend, including flight reports and lots of other videos, and all the other great aircraft in the fleet, available on bydanjohnson.com or bydanjohnson.com.